And this thing that will not be hearers of the word only, but will be doers in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord and our God, we thank you for the opportunity to gather before you and to lay at your feet. We pray, oh God, that our gathering today will not be in vain. As you speak to us, oh God, you will give us the grace to, oh Lord, apply your words, oh God, that we may be better workers. So that at the end of the day, oh Lord, for the short period of time that we're going to hear your word now and to speak, oh God, Father, we pray that your divine presence will envelope us.
Amen.
Oh Lord, we pray that God, you will speak to our heart, that the Holy Spirit will take control.
Amen.
I release myself into your able hands, and I pray, oh God, that you will speak through me.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Workers as an ambassador for Christ. Now, before I go into the topic, I'd like to look at three words and to kind of explain it. I know you know it, but it's good for us to, you know, reason together. So the first word there is a worker. And if I ask the question, who is a worker? We can say a worker is somebody who works. That is very straightforward and easy. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
But a worker is not just somebody who works, because a lot of people are working. But their work will not be counted. A worker is somebody who adds value to the organization that he or she belongs to. You can be working and not adding value. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why there is a reward system at work where, you know, if you are outstanding in what you do, you are rewarded. If you just do the normal, minimal, you know, basic one, you get your normal, minimal, basic pay. But when you are adding a value, you become an asset to the company or to the organization. And they will reward you ultimately for that. So a worker in the household of God is not just a worker by name. It's not just a worker by title. It's not just a worker by the virtue of how long you have been or we have been in the church. It's a worker indeed who adds value to that church or to that local parish. And I want us to quickly open our Bible to Matthew chapter 7, and we're going to read very, very quickly. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Matthew chapter 7. And I will read from 21. It says, not everyone that said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. And many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils? And in thy name done many wonderful things? I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Now, if we look at that scripture, it's not talking to an unbeliever. It's talking to people that are working in the church of God. Because in the Lord's name, they will cast out demons. In the Lord's name, they have done so many things. People outside there don't cast out devils, do they?
No.
We are the ones that do that. But the scripture is saying here that at some point God will say, you know what, I don't even know you. Why? Even though they're workers in the household of God, an ambassador is somebody that when they send forth and they return home, they will be rewarded, they will be appreciated. They are known. They, you know, because they have done a very good job. But we don't know you. Like we heard earlier on, I didn't send you, I didn't call you. You have not done what I asked you to do. You have not. That will not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to seize this opportunity to greet everyone. God bless you, you know, for coming. I'm so glad to be here today. And I know that, in fact, a few minutes that I've been here, I'm already blessed. I believe we're going to all be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And so, the worker must stay in his or her calling and add value to his or her organization. So when we say we are ambassador, therefore, as a worker, we're talking of being a representative of God. Hallelujah. Now, who is an ambassador? An ambassador is a diplomat of the highest rank, sent by one sovereign state to another. It's, you know, somebody that is given the highest rank, you know, somebody that is so important, a post, you know, that is given to someone that you can be uprooted from your country to be sent to another country. You won't just send anybody from your country to go and send to Gucci. You send somebody that is trustworthy. You send somebody that is knowledgeable. You send somebody that is teachable. There was an acronym that, you know, saw my note. You will not send somebody who is not going to be faithful. You cannot say you have an ambassador that is not available when they need the ambassador to do something, it's not there. When your country wants to find out what is happening with the other country, it's not there. When a deal needs to be made, it's not there. It's not available. Hallelujah. And it's not teachable as well. It's not ready to learn. You can't be an ambassador in a country you don't know what is happening in that country. So as a worker who is an ambassador of Christ Jesus, we must know who Jesus Christ is. We must know what our calling is. We must know why we are sent. We must know what we are sent for. Hallelujah. And we must be able to deliver the message and the purpose of God to the people that we are sent to. So an ambassador of Christ, we are as workers. That implies that we're not working for ourselves. An ambassador will not say, you know what, I'm not going to report to my country. I'm not going to report to the prime minister of my country. I'm doing my own thing. That is not possible. That is not what an ambassador will do. You are sent forth to go forth, do what you're supposed to do, and report back. But like we've heard earlier on, most of us, we don't do that. Sometimes our pastors send us on hearing. You know, we're workers, God. We don't go back to say, Pastor, I have done what you asked me to do. Pastor will be chasing us around, you know, calling us up to find out what we've done. That is not the way an ambassador works. And I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. Yeah. I want us to quickly open our Bible to John chapter 4. And I will read very, very quickly. Workers as ambassador of Christ, when we are indeed Christ's ambassador. And I pray that we will not fail him and we will not fail ourselves in Jesus' name. Amen. To be honest with you, we cannot really fail him. Because there's nothing we're going to do that he's not aware of. We can only fail ourselves. And I pray we will not fail ourselves in Jesus' name. Amen. John chapter 4, and I read from 35. Say not ye, there are yet 4 months, and then cometh harvest. Behold, I say unto you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest. And he that reap receive wages, and gather fruits unto life eternal, that both he that sows and he that reap may rejoice together. And herein is that saying true, one sows and other reap. But I sent you to reap that whereon you bestow no labor. All that men labor, and ye are entered into their labors. An ambassador is sent to a country, and you know the benefit that goes with being in that position. My goodness, when you travel, nobody check your luggage. You can carry anything you like. You can carry as many luggages as you like. You have people running helter-skelter, you know, to make sure that you're comfortable. You go into a country and you're treated like a king or queen as an ambassador. But it's not because you have done a fantastic job. What I'm saying in effect is that God has called us. We are privileged to be called as workers to be an ambassador for Christ. You know, people have gone ahead of us. People prayed for us. Some people prayed for us into the kingdom. Hallelujah. Amen. There are people that witnessed to us. There are people that, you know, in the past, we have to go back to history. People that laid down their lives for us. They knew they were going to die when they were there ministering and, you know, sending for the gospel. They laid their lives. Some people have gone ahead of us. They prepared before we came around. Hallelujah to be, you know, the children of God. But that woman says that the ground has been prepared. It is now our turn as an ambassador for Christ to do our bit. Because we are all working together. The scripture says that poor plants are going to water. It is God that gives the increase. Somebody planted, somebody is going to water, and the Lord will give the increase. So as an ambassador, we are workers. We are privileged to be workers. It's an opportunity, you know, for us to be working for God. And we're sent forth, and it's an opportunity we shouldn't take lightly. We are therefore representative. We are messenger. We don't like hearing that word. Nobody likes to be called a messenger. But I don't mind being called a messenger of God. I'd rather be called a messenger of God than being called anything else. Praise the Lord. I'd rather God says to me, oh, you are my messenger. I'll be excited, I'll be happy. Because like we're here, so many people are working for God. Unknown to them, they're not really working for God because there are workers and there are workers. Now, who is Christ? Simply put, is our Lord, Master, and our Savior. When you have a master, the master says go, you go. The master says come, you come. Whatever he says is the final authority. You do not dispute, you cannot dispute or disagree with what the master is saying. But the question I need to ask us is, are we truly Christ's ambassador? Are we truly doing what Christ asks us to do? Are we truly obeying our master? Is Jesus Christ really our master? Because so many times we reason things out. We're very logical, very knowledgeable, very intelligent. We seem to be wiser than God. We seem to know better than God. We've heard of Jonah. God asked him, go to Nineveh. And he decided, I'm not going that way, I'm going this way. He didn't say to God, you know what, I'm not going. He didn't say, God, I will not be going to where you asked me to go. He actually, you know, bothered the sheep as if he was going, but he was going the opposite way. That is what most of us are doing. That is not an ambassador. We must remember that we are ambassadors of Christ Jesus. So a worker is an employee, a workman or woman, a laborer, a volunteer, like most of us are in the Church of God. An ambassador is a minister. So we as workers are also ministers. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And our Lord is the final authority. So the worker, the ambassador, is sent out by the master, who is the final authority. And that is the way it works, that we are workers for Christ. So if we're therefore an ambassador of Christ Jesus, how do we comport ourselves? How do we carry ourselves? You will not expect an ambassador to behave anyhow. You will not expect an ambassador to be unruly. You will not expect an ambassador not to deliver. You will not expect an ambassador not to do the work that he has been sent for to do. So therefore, as workers of the Lord Jesus Christ, we must be able to stand before God and give account of what we have done. Because the time is coming, believe you me, whether we like it or not, whether we believe you or not, it's irrelevant. When people are starting to say, this is what I do, why did you not do this? Is it because your pastor did this? No, it's going to be you and yourself. You're going to answer for yourself, and pastor will answer for his or herself. And the truth of the matter is, sometimes we put too much, we expect too much from the pastors. You want pastor to say thank you. You want pastor to applaud you. You want pastor to appreciate you. And you an ambassador for the pastor, an ambassador for God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Bible says we should walk our salvation with fear and trembling. This pastor himself is walking in salvation. And we need to understand as well that the pastor is human. There are times when the pastor wants to appreciate us, but maybe one thing or the other, they didn't do it for one reason or the other. They are going through, you know, some experiences that we don't even understand. So we need to pray for our pastor. I'm not here to talk about pastor. God bless us. Praise the Lord. So we need to be faithful in our roles. We need to be available. We need to do the work with a sense of urgency. Because as an ambassador, you're not going to be there forever. Hallelujah. There's a time limit. Praise the Lord. You know, we look at our daddy Gio, but we know that Daddy Gio is no longer a young man. Praise God. And the man is still working hard for God. So the time is coming when we'll get to that level where we too will be getting on. So this is the time now. Now is the time. As an ambassador, you are sent out at a particular time for a particular purpose. You have to make use of that opportunity because you will not always be there. It is not a permanent post. An ambassador should be teachable like we've heard. Praise the Lord. An ambassador should be a role model as workers. We role models. What do we do at work? Do people at work know us as Christians? Or do they not even, some of us might not even be known as Christians because of our behavior. You've manifested yourself at work that now to tell them you're a Christian has become a problem because they'll be wondering, what? Some of us were workers for the pastor. We're co-workers working together for the good of the household of faith. And I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Workers as an ambassador for Christ, we must be loyal. You can't the country. If Britain is sending an ambassador to where?
Kuwait.
To Kuwait. You can't go to Kuwait and not be loyal to Britain. You must be loyal. It's amazing that we have some workers that are not loyal to their church. I mean, how can you be a worker you're not loyal to your local parish? What are you doing in that church? You must be loyal to your local assembly. Loyalty implies that you pay your tithe. Of course, some of us don't pay our tithe. God will have mercy on us. Because the scripture, we know what the scripture says about that. And the word of God is yea and amen. We can dissect it. We can, logically reason it out. But what God says will stand. So you must be loyal in your service to your local assembly. You must be loyal to your pastor. You must be loyal in your commitment to what you're doing in the church. You must be loyal in your tithes. Pay your tithes. And God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You cannot serve to, an ambassador will not be serving two countries at the same time. You cannot be serving as an ambassador from UK and then you are an ambassador from Nigeria at the same time. It's not possible. So you cannot be in another church at the same time. You cannot give your best. It's not possible to split yourself into two. So stay in one place and be loyal and be committed. And as you do that, God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So workers as ambassador, an ambassador, we are therefore representative of the Almighty God. Because He is not physically here. We are His mouth. We are His representative. When people see us, they should see Christ in us. The scripture tells us that the Christians in Antioch, they were first called Christian. Why? Simply because they were representative of Jesus Christ. Jesus did not give them that name. But when people saw them, they saw that these people represented Christ Jesus. They said, these are Christian. They are Christ-like. That is what people should see. We're not talking of us being perfect because we're a work in progress. But we're talking of us doing the will of God. And whilst we're doing the will of God, God will perfect His will in our lives as well.
Amen.
An ambassador of a country is expected to make known to that country where he's sent to the purpose, the mind of the country he's representing. Who are we representing? Are we representing ourselves? Or are we representing God? Do we speak the word of God? Do we speak the mind of God? Do we speak the purpose of God? When you are sent forth as an ambassador, you are supposed to carry a message from your country to the other country. What message are we carrying? Are we carrying the message of God? God will help us in Jesus' name. Can we quickly open our Bible to Romans chapter 10, verse 8? We need to speak the mind of Christ. It says, for once they are eat, the word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. We must speak the word in our actions and our reactions. We must speak Christ. We must let people know who we are and what we stand for. That is why we are workers, ambassadors for Christ. And if Ephesians 6, now read from verse 19 rather. Hallelujah. We're not working for ourselves, we're bought with a price. And the person who bought us, we're going to report to at some point. Amen. And God is going to help us so that we will not miss it. It says, and for me that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in bonds, that wherein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. Being an ambassador for Christ doesn't imply that you will find it comfortable. It is not a comfortable thing to do when you are an ambassador for Christ. You speak in season and you speak out of season. Use the word speak, not literally, but what you do, what you say, where you are. Like we heard that our pastor is here this morning, but it wasn't comfortable for her. It's not always going to be comfortable. And us as workers, we need to move on from being convenient worker. Convenient Christianity is not going to help us in this day and age. It doesn't matter what obtains out there, but it's no longer convenient Christianity. When it's comfortable for me, I will do it. When it's comfortable for me, I will say no. The time is going and we need to rise up. It says, I'm in bond, but I'm an ambassador in bonds. Hallelujah. I'm in prison, but I'm an ambassador for Christ. I will speak out. I will act out. I will stand and be counted for Christ, regardless of the situation I find myself. That is an ambassador. You must speak. You must act. People must know that you have a mission, and that mission must be accomplished in the of Christ in our lives will not be mission impossible.
Amen.
Because we know we have the power and the grace of God in our lives. You must be filled and be led by the Holy Spirit. As an ambassador of Christ, this work is not by power, it's not by might, but by my spirit says the Lord. Hallelujah. You cannot be Christ's ambassador if you're not led by the Spirit. You cannot just be, you know, hit and miss Christian. You know, I do it this way. If it doesn't work, I do it the other way. You know, having contingency plans here and there. You know, you don't know where you are going, whether you're going or coming. You're being tossed to and fro like the reeds of the sea. Hallelujah. An unstable Christian. An unstable person cannot be an ambassador. You have to be stable. And therefore, you need the Holy Spirit to help you. The scripture tells us in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, and ye shall receive power. After with the Holy Spirit has come upon you. I mean, looking around us these days as Christians, how many of us can survive as Christians without the presence of the Holy Spirit? You know, the most of the problem we're having is because we're not led by the Spirit. We don't know when we need to speak. We don't know what we need to do. We don't know how we need to do it. We're just doing it by okay, by experience. Residual knowledge of life of yesteryears. How we used to do it. How our fathers in the Lord used to do it and are still doing it. Copy, you know, people here and there. We need to be led of the Spirit. Because as men as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons and the daughters of God. And we know that when the Holy Spirit leads us, He will lead us into righteousness, into holiness. He will help us. He will speak to us. Amen. There is nothing about our life that God cannot talk to us about. After all, He said, even you should not be anxious. The hair on your head, He said, I know every single strand. And if I know every single strand of the hair on your head, how much more? He knows our problems and He knows our challenges. So we need to be led of the Holy Spirit so that we can truly be a good ambassador. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Without the Holy Spirit, we can do nothing. Without the Holy Spirit, our gathering will just be social gathering. Without the Holy Spirit, we might be talking, but we're not ministering. We can sing, but we're not ministering. We can talk to people, they're listening, but that's the end of it. For us to impact lives, for us to leave a legacy, for us after we have left our post as an ambassador, for people to remember that so-so-so was here, it will take the presence of the Holy Spirit in our lives for us to make a mark. And the reason Jesus sent us forth as ambassador is for us to make a mark. He did not send the 12 disciples just for the fun of it. They were 12 disciples, mostly illiterate, who didn't even know their left from their right, but they shook the world of their own time. How much more us, extremely intelligent set of people, with all the technological development around us, we have everything available. Do you think the disciples didn't go through the same similar problem we were going through? They went through the same problem. They were persecuted. They had their own fair share of problems, but they went through it and they succeeded. We must succeed and will succeed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit will lead us in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Finally, I want to say we should not forget ourselves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In John chapter 15, 16, what did He say? Hallelujah. He is our source. He called us. He didn't call it. He called us to be an ambassador. Praise the Lord. You know,
Hallelujah.
Before we were formed in our mother's womb, He was anyway. He ordained us. He knew what he was going to do with us. Jesus Christ called us. It's not the other way around. So you follow the person who calls you. You cannot be ahead of the person that calls you. We cannot be ahead of Christ. So we must always remember that Jesus Christ is our source. And that is where the issue of prayer comes in. We must always go back to him. Because when we pray, we talk to him and let him, we're telling him that our dependency is not of ourselves. We're depending on you, O God. Hallelujah. Amen. It's our sufficiency. We know that it's our source, it's our strength, it's our joy, and it's our everything. So we must, as workers, when we're not sure about something happening in the church, when we're not sure of things that are around us, what do? We take it back to the source. When our car is having a problem, what do? We take it back to the manufacturer. Or we go back to the source. And that is how we can be a true ambassador. And I pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Please let us remember and bear in mind that whatever we do, however we do it, the time is coming when we have to stand before God. Pastor may not know, the GO may not know, your friends may not know what you're up to, but God knows. And the time is coming, he's going to split and separate the true worker from workers. There are so many people, many are called, but few are chosen. He says, his disciples went to him at some point and said, "Oh, God, no. We planted wheat. What is going on here? There are wheat." He said, "Leave them. Let them grow together." As workers, we're all growing together. But the time is coming when the master will separate the wheat from the wheat. And I pray that we will not be wheat in Jesus' name. Amen. And at the end of the day, he will not say to us, "Yes, you were in the church. Yes, you were running around. Yes, you were full of activities. Yes, you did everything that you think you should be doing, but I never sent you to do that. You depart from me, workers of iniquity." That will not be our portion.
Amen.
I pray rather that the Almighty God will say to us, "Thou faithful, responsible, sincere servant. You had a little, but that little you used it to the glory of my name." That will be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
My Lord and our God, we just want to thank you for this opportunity, O God, to remind ourselves, because we know already that we are called as workers to be your ambassadors. But we pray, O God, that you will give us the grace, the ability, the strength, that when we're lacking, O God, Lord God Almighty, you will arise on our behalf.
Amen.
And you will help us to stand, O God, and be counted for you.
Amen.
Help us to be a true ambassador indeed. But we pray in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.